Good morning, children. It's good to see you again. Wish I could. Today's lesson is called Saul and King. And our verse today is, in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. And that comes out of Proverbs 3:6. And our aim today, the moral of our story today that we want to go and keep thinking about is that we need to choose to do what is right no matter what others are doing. Israel kind of made a mistake in that area, and we're going to learn about that today. Now, Samuel was Israel's judge for many years. We remember Samuel. He was the child that Hannah wanted, and she had a son, and she dedicated him to the Lord. And so he was their judge for many years, and he traveled around the towns and cities visiting people and teaching them about God. Well, one day, the elders of Israel came to Samuel, and they said, "You are getting old now, and there is no one else like you to look after the people, so we've decided we want a king. We want to have a king just like all the other nations." Well, Samuel was very upset because he had been trying to teach these Israelites all this time to trust in God and that God was their king. Well, so he went and he prayed and he talked to God about it. And God says, "Well, don't feel bad, Samuel. It isn't you that they don't want. It's me that they're rejecting, that they're turning away from." So God told Samuel to let them have a king just like the other nations around them. But Samuel was to tell the people some of the things that would happen to them if they had a king. So he went to them and he said, "If you have a king," Samuel said, "he will be like the kings of the other nations. He will want to keep a trained army, so he will take your sons and he will make them serve him as soldiers. And he will want to build himself a palace or maybe improve his city, and so he'll take your sons and your daughters as servants. But worst of all, it will feel like you need to go to the king for wisdom instead of asking God." But the Israelites said, "We want a king." Well, one day, a man named Saul was out looking for his father's donkeys. They had taken off and had left home, and so him and his servant was out looking for the donkeys, and they walked many, many miles searching for them. Well, finally, Saul said, "Oh, we need to go home. Let's go home. By now, my father will be more worried about us than he is about the donkeys." The servant said, he says, "Wait, I just thought of something. There is a prophet who lives in a city near here. Let's go and find him. Maybe he can tell us where the donkeys are." So they went to the city where the prophet lived, and just as they neared the gate, they saw Samuel. Well, God had spoken to Samuel the day before, and he said, "Be ready about this time tomorrow." He said, "I will send you a man from the land of Benjamin. You are to anoint him as the leader of my people." Well, of course, when Samuel saw Saul, God said to him, "This is the man." God made it very, very clear to Samuel who he had chosen to be the king that these people wanted. So Saul unsuspectingly walked right up to Samuel and said, "Can you tell me where the prophet's house is?" Well, Samuel answered, "I am the man to whom you are looking. Come and have a meal with me, and don't worry about the donkeys that were lost. They have been found, and your father is not worried about you." So while Saul looked at him in astonishment, Samuel said, "You are the man that the people of Israel have been wanting. You are to be their king." Well, then Samuel took Saul and his servant to a great dining hall where there were 30 other guests. Well, Saul was given the place of honor at the head of the table and a special portion of the food. After the feast, Samuel took Saul up to the roof of the house and they talked for a long time, and when he grew sleepy, he gave him a bed for the night. Well, the next morning when the men started to leave for home, Samuel walked with them. And he told Saul to send his servant on ahead. And then Samuel took a bottle of anointing oil and he poured it over Saul's head. And he said, "I am doing this because God has chosen you. You are to be the king of his people." Samuel told Saul about certain events that would take place on his way home. And Saul said goodbye and started for home. Well, everything happened exactly as Samuel had said, which helped Saul to believe that what the prophet had told him was true. He really was the man chosen by God. Well, some days later, Samuel called all the people together and reminded them of all God had done for Israel since he brought them out of Egypt. And he said that God was not pleased that they did not trust him to look after them. But since they wanted a king, God would show them who it was to be. So back then they drew lots, what they called lots, to go and narrow things down. It's kind of like rolling a dice, I guess. But one by one, all the tribes of Israel came forward. And the tribe of Benjamin was chosen. So some of the people stepped out of line, so to speak. And then the family of Kish was chosen. So that eliminated some more people. And finally, Saul was chosen. And the people went crazy. And they said, "Long live the king," everyone shouted. The Israelites were pleased to have Saul as their king. But as they looked for Saul, they couldn't find him. He was hiding. So they searched and they searched around, and finally they found him hiding in behind some of the wares that were for sale in the city. And Saul came before him. And Samuel again anointed him and told them that this was the man that God had chosen to be their king. But just as Samuel had told them, they had a lot of trouble. And all the trouble come because they wanted to be like the other countries around them. Instead of trusting God to take care of them and to lead them and to be their king, they had decided that they needed to be like the other countries. Well, one thing to remember as you go through this life, we are much happier when we choose to obey God and do everything His way. So, as you stop and look and talk with your family and such about this lesson, here are some questions to think about while you're discussing this lesson. So, why did the people want a king? And what did God use to bring Saul to Samuel? And the third question would be, why was it wrong for Israel to want to have a king? I just thank you for joining me again today, and I pray that God would bless your week. Bye.